Okay, before I start this video, because I forgot during the actual filming, during the actual recording, I want to give a huge shout out to two people of the Nesero server. First of all, I want to give a shout out to Penny. She has been a great support for me. Overall, and especially with the industrial craft agriculture system. So hi Penny. And second of all, as well, a big shout out to Kolk. He is one of the admins on the server, and he has not more than help. It's like these people actually have patience with me and understand that I'm like from a different culture and I speak a different language, and they overlook my language mistakes and my writing, and they just have a lot of patience. So I want to especially thank you guys, Penny and Kolk, and let's get on with the video. Hello and welcome, people of YouTube, to a new Nesero server update. Since the last time, let's start over. Let's begin with what I've shown you so far. So I have shown you so far, the first video was our starting point, which had a little bit of red power, had a little bit of industrial crafts. The second video had the starting of the sorting system, and by starting I mean 2 days of work. Okay, and now for the third video, I want to show you a part of what have we built so far, and some of it I will leave for another video, in which I will do it with Fineshine X, because that thing that we want to show you is a full on how do you say in English, collaboration. So that's like our pièce de résistance. Okay, I wanted to show you this in the night time, but unfortunately someone on the server came by and I had a little chat with him, and I forgot about it. So let me show you this in daytime, unfortunately. Probably by the end of the video it will get nighttime again, so we'll be able to see that in the nighttime. So this is our home, our new home, the castle in which you saw the second episode take place. I have modified a little bit the road in here because it was all wooden, and I've put these two lava lamps in the entrance. Oh, and it's raining, how lucky of me. Now and storm. Okay. I won't go very far into detail. I'll just say it is awesome. So let me, oh come on, center it, there we go. Let me show you the finished red power sorting system. So not much has changed in here. Again, the sorting system, the quick processing area over here, I have changed a little bit the texture, because I wanted a new texture for like the wooden chests, and you'll see the wood, of course, I've changed a little bit, and maybe the glass. So this is the processing area. This I have finally finished it. We have in here 3 macerators and 3 furnaces, okay, electric furnaces. What you see, these guys are all MFEs. Don't worry about the texture with the dot, it does that in SMP apparently. Okay, I have added to the system a relay over here, because when the system was overflowing. The these filters wouldn't accept any more items, so I had to put a relay in there just to accept new items. Okay, so that gives me a nine space inventory as a buffer, basically, and even more because it shoots down every single item in the inventory if he detects only one space for it. Okay, change a little bit the timer on the systems to be automated. So basically, whenever this contraption detects that it needs to macerate, so whenever power is getting through this line from the MFE over here, okay, this NOT gate inverts and that timer goes on with, I think it's a 500 milliseconds, so half a second interval in there, and powers these retrievers, which allows me to get all the things back. When I power it on, I get a little bit of lag, but it's fully automated, so I like that. Don't worry about this for now. Again, the same system here with the quick processing line. This is our mass fabricator system. Okay, we have an MFSU in here. Again, this is the mass fabricator itself. All right, these are five recyclers that I have set up in such a way that only get cobble through this pipe. Again, a filter just for cobble and a relay because I like that. So the relay gets the cobble and distributes it to the recyclers. Here I have five transposers, one for each recycler, and a timer set on a very short interval for 100 milliseconds. So whenever I power off this lever, these transposers take the scrap from the recyclers directly into another relay. So as you see, I have used a lot the relay, and I think it's a very useful block to have from Red Power. And that relay deposits everything into this mass fabricator, which again on, I have a lever on it to power on and off. This is a high voltage to medium voltage transformer. And on in the floor just underneath it, I have a medium voltage to low voltage and a line to take that low voltage to these recyclers. So it's not a fully automated system, but it doesn't need to be because this is very very laggy. So I only power it when I need to. I don't know if I showed you in the last update the cobble generator setup, so let me do that really quick. Again, the basement here is the system that basically gets all the overflowing cobble and drops it on a cactus. Okay, in here we have some mag tubes that get the cobble from outside the claim, because as you know, the block breakers don't work inside the claim, and it gets the cobble into upstairs into the recyclers. So let's go really quick and show you the cobble generator system. Oh, come on, long little line, and here under the old house we have the cobble generator. So a pillar of lava, a pillar of water, a block breaker on a timer that first of all fills up this chest over here, and this little system. Okay, I get the power from these water mills with the generic water mill system. Okay, into the bad box that powers an induction for an electric furnace, and I get over here some smooth stone. So transposer puts it in there, and from there you get in there with some smooth stone. A very simple system, not much. It's not very fast because I don't need it to be fast. I just need it like every 5.5 seconds to get some smooth stone, because I don't need it that much. So also these are powered off. Remember, every single system you do has to have a power off switch. Here, of course, some red power generators for mossy stone brick. This will eventually become somewhat automated, because I can't really fully automate it without putting a block breaker outside my claim. So we'll see about that. I have a design in mind. I also discussed it with FunshineX. We'll see about it. Come on, push the button, please. There you go. Thank you. As well, all the doors in the house have a custom delay time. It's about 3 seconds. I'll show that in just a second, because I have somewhere where it is in plain sight, so I don't have to break now the blocks. Okay, so I have showed you a little bit the castle. I won't go into detail. I will let again FunshineX to show you. Oh, this is the my texture for the glass. I played a little bit with it. Let's get into the piece of resistance of my building skills, which is a farm that I just wanted a farm to dedicate to industrial craft farming. And I initially said to FunshineX, dude, I want you to build me a farm. And well, he couldn't just build me a farm, of course. He needed to build like a full building and stuff like that. So and I don't know, I didn't like it, because it was not symmetrical. And I don't know if you know me, guys, but I like things to be symmetrical. So I took the project in my own hands a little bit. So I basically went from his design, which was the lower part, and modified until I got sick, and then modified some more. And this is what I ended up with. So welcome to my farm. It has a cathedral-ish feel to it, of course. Here on the side, some actually, let me put smooth lighting on, because this looks better with smooth lighting. There we go. I used a lot of red power blocks in it, so yeah. So some vines here and there, some archways. Okay, you go down a little bit. This will eventually be stone bricks. Alright, so this you can imagine everything is symmetrical. So if I show you, one side is the same on the other side. You get in here. Yeah, okay, you have a small door. And this is again not finished. I'll show you that a little bit later. Let's go on the other side. As I've said, symmetrical, because I like it that way, damn it. whoa. Oh, come on. A little bit of lag, no worries. Actually, not lag. My Minecraft just can't handle also recording and running on smooth lighting and such. This is the back of the building. This is entirely done by FunshineX. So, yeah. This is basically the single thing he did symmetrical. I really like the towers. He came up with the zipper design, so I continued them a little bit higher, and yeah. Okay, let's finally go inside. Let's see if I can hit this button. Yay! Okay, so this is where we had our old house. This basically is not finished, as I've said. Okay, here was the old chests. Okay, here is the system for the doors. It's very simple, very basic, but it helps a lot with the doors. So you have a jacketed wire from each of the buttons. Okay, so I have a button on that side and a button on this side. I have a wire in here, so when I push the button, this toggle latch, toggle, not, no, no, this RS latch, I always forget the names, this memory cell, I like to call them memory cells. So this memory cell toggles on this side, which allows this timer to go for 3 seconds, as you can see. And when the timer reaches 3 seconds, it toggles the gate again on the other side. It's as simple as that. Very simple, very practical, the same system over here. I didn't put that in parallel, I just put it on the vertical line. It's the same system. A latch and a timer, very, very simple. You might be wondering what's with the water pillar. Well, my friends, let's go a little bit upstairs. Okay, first of all, this is the second floor. Am I right? Yeah, I think I'm right. English and me, yes, best of friends. Okay, so this is the second floor of the house. Again, these windows were made by Funshine X, and I really liked them, so I kept them. I destroyed a lot of stuff in here just to make some room. Okay, this is so I've said this is the second floor, and let's go now to the third and final floor, which is the most amazing and is I think fully my creation, if I'm not mistaken. So this is basically the glass dome and my industrial craft farm area. Glass all around the pillars, as you can see, the zip line or whatever it's called, the zip motif. A little bit of French. This in here is like the skylight for the areas below it. It's basically a large circle, so nothing too fancy. These are some aqueducts that I really liked the idea. I got it from one of Zisto's movies. Zisto is a guy that makes videos for YouTube. He's also on the Minecraft server, so if you know Good or BOO, he's one of the guys that plays on that server, and he's one of those guys that like to do things in order and symmetrical. And he built recently on the Minecraft server, he built an awesome aqueduct system, and I wanted to steal a little bit from his idea, so I did this guy. Okay, take a little bit of damage, no worries. It's not incredibly practical, because the industrial craft crops need sunlight, from my understanding. So it leaves them room for sunlight through the water and the glass, but that means because I have this water pillar in here, I can't put in there a crop matron from industrial craft. So yeah, this is the basic system I use in four other spots. So I have one over there, one over there, one over here, and actually the first one I used is over here. It's a crop matron with a bat box and a low voltage solar array on top. So that's my basic system. Let me show you again from up top. So we have each single square is a 9x9. Okay, and I do my crossbreeding in those. The industrial craft part of this server is a little bit glitchy, especially with the textures. Whenever I unload this chunk from my memory, all the crops revert to visually revert to empty crops, so I have no idea what's in them. So each time I come to this area, I have to wait a little bit for the crops to update when they grow, or I have to do it manually. Okay, another small system I have done here, because I was getting tired of sorting everything by hand, I have put here another relay. Okay, and whenever I get seeds or byproducts from these guys, I put them in the relay and they get sorted down here. Okay, into these chests, which are of course labeled. So as you can see, pumpkin, wheat, blackthorn, sizing. I have labeled with also the tiers of each plant I will eventually have or discover. And as you can see, I have gone old school and lazy style, because I have not put in here a sorting machine. I have just put filters on each and every single chest, and that tube that gets from the relay just goes over all the filters, and when it sees that it can go into that filter, it drops the item below. And if nothing goes into the filter, it goes in this last chest over here, which is of course an overflow chest, a thing you should also always have in your red power system. So a little bit of automation, not much. Also, I have in here a recycler, because a lot of the crop seeds I have are no good for me. So I put a recycler in here. This is a regular solar panel with a bat box recycler, some project tables, and of course a golden chest for my weed eggs and such and such. Okay, this is about it for the third update on the Nesteros server. What can I say? A lot of fun. If you guys are not much into construction and what can I say, gadgets and automated systems, Nesteros also has on this server like PvE arenas, so player versus environment, or even PvP arenas. If you're into that kind of stuff, and a few of the guys on the server really like the PvE arena. So if you want to go onto the server, you can do that with no worries. So yeah, see you next time when I do with FunshineX an update video on a pretty awesome system we built. And also I want him to show you guys our small automated tree farm. Okay, so he has put some time into that, and I'm hoping he will finish it, because he wants to use computers, you know, like with fourth, I want to say, from Red Power. So let's hope he'll do that for us soon. So until next time, please rate, comment and subscribe. And as always guys, don't forget to be awesome. Ciao.